Hanna Schygulla was born in Poland on Christmas Day in 1943. Starting with her childhood, which is kind of dark and grim, Hanna's father was a timber merchant who was summoned as an infantryman in the German army. He was eventually captured as a prisoner of war during World War II by American forces in Italy. In 1945, being just 2 years old, Hanna and her mother were forced to move to a refugees camp in Munich, Germany, where she spent most of her childhood. Throughout her teenage years and her studies, Hanna originally wanted to become a teacher. However, her life took an unexpected turn. While taking acting lessons in her free time, she met the one and only Rainer Werner Fassbinder. In the mid-1960s, Schygulla and Fassbinder were enrolled in the same Munich acting school. Schygulla remembers her first impression of Fassbinder.
He was extremely shy, but also daring. During improvisations, his approach was always different from the others. There was never a cliché.
From their first meeting, they were rarely apart from that point on. Fassbinder was known to be a cruel and evil man to everyone around him. He was never seen without a leather jacket, a cigarette, and a beer. Or three. His addiction to alcohol and cocaine only added to his harshness, and anyone that entered his orbit was cruelly manipulated. Hanna was one of the lucky few who avoided being tricked or majorly hurt by Fassbinder.
He didn't torture me. He knew he could only get things for me if he made me feel he liked what I was doing.
To put things into perspective, actors and actresses felt uncomfortable with Fassbinder on set, and two of his past lovers and actors from his films later hanged themselves. Even his roommate threatened to kill herself and attempted suicide on multiple occasions, and Fassbinder only belittled her more. Needless to say, Fassbinder was a marvelously talented actor, but was not a good man, not in the slightest. Fassbinder casted Hanna in his debut film, Love is Colder Than Death, in which he played a petty gangster, and she played his gorgeous housewife and plaything named Joanna, alongside two male protagonists. This film is interesting because Hanna's character is referred to as, and pardon my language, a whore on multiple occasions, yet is a pretty strong and smart female character. Hanna's character ultimately is the leading factor for a major plot point in the film, in which she secretly tips off the cops to get another protagonist killed. In 1974, Fassbinder wrote and directed the film Effie Briest, starring, you guessed it, Hanna Schygulla. The film was about a 19th century woman who had an affair with a classic womanizer. Throughout the film, we see how this affair has long-term effects on the woman's marriage to an older man. Hanna's performance as Effie is considered one of her strongest performances ever. An article posted by Peter Burnett put it like this: she seems to play a young, intelligent, happy girl one moment, and then a much older, dying mother the next. During the making of Effie, Fassbinder and Hanna became distant, and after it was finished, she left him for other work, in which she wasn't as successful in her efforts. Unfortunately for Schygulla, she was Fassbinder's muse and star, therefore any work she did with other directors was significantly less remarkable in comparison. After 4 years, Fassbinder and Schygulla reconciled in 1978 for his film The Marriage of Maria Braun, which is one of their biggest commercial successes. Hanna played Maria, who was dealing with an unfulfilled marriage to a soldier during World War II. Maria then completely changes to the realities of post-war Germany at the time and becomes a wealthy mistress of an industrialist at the time, whilst trying to stay true to her love for her husband. Most of the roles Schygulla played were sexy and sultry women, yet Schygulla made it her mission to take risks, experiment, and change. She was a very versatile actress because of this. After the filming of The Marriage of Maria Braun, once again, Fassbinder and Schygulla's relationship took another knock. In 1981, Fassbinder intentionally made sure that Schygulla was being paid less than her male co-star in the film, Lily Marleen. In this film, Hanna plays Willy, a German singer who has fallen in love with the Swiss Jewish composer Robert. Their love is forbidden, making this film a classic German wartime melodrama. After this film, Schygulla leaves Fassbinder once again and tries to do work with other directors. Later in that year, in 1981, Schygulla was informed that Fassbinder had left phone messages for her. She shrugged them off, thinking that she'd be in Paris soon enough and that she could call or speak to him then. Unfortunately for her, her friend and director for years, Fassbinder, died from a drug overdose at just 37. Jumping ahead a little bit to the present day, in an interview with Hanna, she was asked if she visits her grave. Her response really interested me. She said,
"What for? It's just a couple of bones. I have my corner in my apartment where I keep the portraits of those who belong to me. He is there."
What interested me is that after years of drama and success and partial abuse, Fassbender meant a lot to Schygulla, and I just thought that was pretty cool. After her major acting career with Fassbender, Schygulla was never able to maintain a compelling star persona. She was popular because of Fassbender. Again, she was his muse. Most people think that when Fassbender died, so did Schygulla's career, but this is simply not the case. Because of her work with Fassbender, she became a chanteuse and a chanson singer in Paris in her mid-50s. She completely reinvented herself and succeeded in doing so. Unfortunately, at the height of her fame as a chanson singer, she withdrew from the stardom and all of the fame to care for her parents. Hanna now lives in Paris. She is 78 years old.